Now we will include one last validation in the name input text field. As it is a name field, I want to restrict the field to allow only English alphabets and space. It should not allow any numbers or special characters. For definition of this validation, again we are going to use HTML. HTML supports pattern attribute, which can be used to check a regular expression pattern. We have to include the pattern attribute in the name input text field. Including the pattern attribute will exceed the width available here, so I am making the input text field to be in a separate line and the closing div tag in the following line. Then I am wrapping the name input text element attributes in two lines with some indent so that there is sufficient space available. After the min length attribute, I am including the pattern attribute. For value of the pattern attribute, first I am including an open square bracket. Then a-z in lowercase. Then a-z in uppercase followed by a space. Then a closing bracket followed by an asterisk. This pattern attribute value defined is a regular expression. Learning regular expression is beyond the scope of this course. Go through relevant documents in internet searching for the keywords regular and expression. The a to z in lowercase denotes that the regular expression allows all the lowercase alphabets. The a to z in uppercase denotes that the regular expression allows all the uppercase characters. The space after capital Z denotes that space is allowed. The square brackets denotes that all these validations needs to be performed on each character of the text typed. The asterisk denotes that there can be any number of characters allowed. Based on this pattern definition, we will see how it works. I am saving the file. After the page reload, I am typing an alphabet. We can see the minimum length validation message displayed. Then I am typing a number. In the errors object, we can see two properties. One is min length. This is because of the reason that only two characters are typed. In the two characters typed, one character is a number, so the regular expression pattern validation fails. Hence, pattern object is also included in the errors object. Based on the pattern object included in the errors property, I am going to include the validation message in the HTML template. I am copying the mandatory field validation message div tag and pasting it below. Then changing required to pattern. Then clearing the current validation message and changing it as only English alphabets and space allowed. I am saving the file. After the page reload, I am typing an alphabet. The minimum length message is displayed. Then I am typing a number. We can see an additional message displayed which requests the user to enter only English alphabets. I am clearing the number. The English alphabets message is gone. I am clearing the alphabet. The mandatory field message is now displayed. If I enter the name as Robert space Smith, then we can see that it is accepted and does not have any validation errors. Hope this explanation helps you understand how complex validations can be implemented using pattern attribute. Let me summarize the steps to be done. Make the input text element in a separate line followed by closing div tag in a separate line. Wrap the attributes of input text elements in a new line as per your convenience. Include the pattern attribute with this regular expression in the input text element. Then include this div tag to display the respective validation message. Save and check if the validation works in all scenarios.